coming up next on the Living Faith Network. Showdown of Faith.
It's happening in every neighborhood.
Why you really want to leave me?
No, I didn't.
Down every street. Sickness. Addiction. And violence has been turning countless homes into crime scenes. Suffering, depressed, alone, suicidal.
Well, God is with you, and this situation of yours is going to change.
But this show is here to bring hope to the hopeless, to prove to you that there is a solution. Now, on the air with Bishop Joshua. The Showdown of Faith.
Wake up, America. The Spirit of God is with you. May the Lord Jesus bless you this Saturday. And for sure he will, because he is not a God that changed his mind. He is not a man. Human being changed their mind. But the Lord is not a man that he should lie, nor change his mind. That's why I say to you this Saturday, God will bless your life, and he is going to do something great, amazing, upon your life. Be awakened. Be awake. Be in faith. Forget about yesterday, the past week. Let us move forward, because this Saturday is a day chosen by God to bless your life. Stay with me, because we have a lot to show to you today. Together with me, I have Nori. She's the one responsible to receive your name, your problems, and place inside of this holy oil. Nori, good day to you.
Good day to you as well, Bishop Joshua, and to all the Showdown of Faith viewers. You can begin to call our helpline. We do have the team of faith available, ready to help you to answer your call. The number that you can dial, 1-888-332-4141. You can give them your name and the problem, your prayer request. Once I have it, I'll place it here inside of the holy oil. You can also feel free to send your prayer request through text message. And if you prefer to text, that number, 1-888-312-4141. The team of faith is there. You have the text message. And before the end of the program, Bishop Joshua, you'll be making a special prayer for all the viewers.
They will be available to receive your call. As she said, just call us. You have nothing to lose. I want you to see the highlight of our first testimony today. You are going to see the story of Mrs. Barry. This lady that tried to kill herself many times, several times, and I'll be back to talk to you, especially you who are suicidal.
My battle with depression started when I was between 13 and 15. That was when I had my first suicide attempt. I took pills. I was not happy. I didn't like myself. I went to the doctor, and they diagnosed me with depression, bipolar, put me on medication, and the medication just really made it worse. Crazy thoughts of killing yourself, and the thought that was in my head and in most people's head is when you want to kill yourself, you're thinking and believing that it's better for everybody that you're dead. I had thoughts of shooting myself. I wanted to die, but I didn't want to die in pain. So pills was my choice, because I'm like, let me take the pills. It'll put me to sleep. I won't wake up anymore. Or it'll give me a heart attack and die. Some of my family members would say, oh, Becky, she's just crazy. It made me worse.
Every 40 seconds, 40 seconds, someone loses their life due to suicide. You are in a dark place. You are in a dark situation. Mrs. Becky, she attempted suicide several times. Praise God, she's still alive by coming to this ministry and knowing the power of God. If you are in a dark situation and there is a voice telling to your mind, kill yourself, take your life, I want you to give my call right now. Perhaps you even called the hotline, but now you are going to call the helpline and somebody will help you. If you are suicidal, I want you to watch this documentary. Perhaps you are also included in it.
Most people who choose to end their lives do so for complex reasons. Research has shown that 90% of people who attempt or die by suicide have a mental illness. Most commonly, depression or an alcohol problem. In many cases, suicide is also linked to feelings of hopelessness and worthlessness. Many experts believe a number of things determine how vulnerable a person is to suicidal thinking and behavior. These include life history. For example, having a traumatic experience during childhood, a history of sexual or physical abuse, or a history of parental neglect. Mental health. For example, developing a serious mental health condition, such as schizophrenia. Lifestyle. For example, if you misuse drugs or alcohol. Employment. Such as poor job security, low levels of job satisfaction, or being unemployed. Relationships. Being socially isolated, being a victim of a bully, or having few close relationships. A new theory by psychologists state the three main factors can cause someone to turn to suicide. These are a wrong perception of themselves, thinking that they are alone in the world and that no one really cares about them. A feeling that they are a burden on others and that people would be better off if they were dead. Fearlessness towards pain or death. It's said that fearlessness poses the biggest risk that someone will commit a successful suicide attempt. It's claimed that fearlessness towards pain explains why self-harm is linked to suicide, as well as why suicide rates are higher in occupations that are linked to exposure to death, such as soldiers, nurses, or doctors.
That was exactly the situation of Mrs. Becky. In a few, you are going to watch and see the testimony, because she was just like that. Suicidal, depressed, but she overcame suicide. She's alive. You don't need to take your life to solve a problem. Bring your problems to the one that can solve them for you. I have someone on the line, but before I speak to this person, Lori, do you already have names?
I absolutely have names already of those who've called the helpline. We have Jesse from Ohio, who wants to be set free from insomnia and wants healing. Jesse, your name is here inside of the holy oil. We will be praying for you. We have Ms. Geraldine. She is asking prayer for her son to be set free from drug addiction. We have Mr. Edwards, who is asking prayer for good health. And we also have Ms. Taylor. She is asking prayer for healing in her body. Mrs. Taylor and those mentioned, your names are here inside of the holy oil, and we will be praying for all of you. You can give us a call to speak to someone, to speak to one of the counselors, or you can feel free to reach out through text message as well.
It doesn't matter how you are, what your pain, or what your suffering is. Jesus Christ is telling you now, speak out, I'm all ears.
Speak out, I'm all ears. When you are suicidal, there is a voice inside of you telling you, take your life, kill yourself, Let me go to the line. Speak to this person from Florida. This lady wants to remain anonymous. Hello?
Hello?
I'm going to call you Miss Mary. Miss Mary, do you have suicidal thoughts?
Yes.
Which are the thoughts in your mind? Which thoughts?
To kill myself, take all my medication.
There is a voice telling you to take all the medication.
Yes, a voice tells me to kill myself. I've been suffering from depression for about 2 years now.
How many years you said?
2 years.
2 years. Okay. And the voice, tell me, so that I can help you and help others. The voice in your mind tells you what? To take medications, what else?
Yes, and it just tells me that, you know, everybody's tired of waiting on me, my family, and, you know, it sends me into arguments and just every little thing I get depressed over because I'm only my age and my mom is in her 80s and she's waiting on me and it just bothers me so much and it sends us into argument, but I think it's mostly me from the depression because I'm depressed because
How old are you?
I'm 60.
Mrs. Mary, let me tell you something. The evil spirit is the same one that causes problem. This is the strategy of this evil spirit. He causes problems in one's life, diseases, misery, unemployment, family separation, depression. A person feels depression, discriminate himself. This is what the evil spirit does, okay?
Yes.
And at the end, this evil tells you to kill yourself, to take your life. But they are the ones that causes problem, like to squeeze you, problems coming from everywhere. At the end, the same evil tell you as a solution, the evil spirit tells you, kill yourself. He wants you to take your life because the spirit doesn't have hands. Spirit is invisible. So the spirit wants you to use your own hands to take a knife, to take the gun, to shoot yourself, to overdose yourself. Never think that after death, the suffering finish. No, it doesn't. After death, the problem does not stop there. After death, the problem is even greater. If in life you suffer like this, after death, you can multiply it 1,000 times more. The suffering, the pain. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
But the evil spirit never tells you that if you kill yourself, you increase the pain, you increase the problem. I am telling you this. All right?
Yes, I hear you.
You don't need to take your life to solve the problem, to solve the depression, the diseases, the family problem. No. God will solve your problems and you are going to be happy as never before.
Yes. I believe that. I do everything that I think I'm supposed to do. You know, I read my Bible. I sow seeds. I've been sowing. And
Let me tell you something. Mrs. Mary, let me tell you something. Do not stop what you are doing, reading the Bible, praying, using your faith. All that you do before the Lord is not in vain. But what I want you to do is that never give up.
Never give up.
I met one lady in prison. She might be in her 50s. And this lady in prison, she was just like you. She was telling me, I want to die, I want to kill myself, I want to disappear. And I told this lady, I forbid you of giving up. 2 weeks ago, I met the same lady in prison. She said to me, I am forbidden of giving up. I don't want to give up. I want to live. I don't want to die. So just say to yourself, I cannot give up. In Jesus' name, I want to live. I want to have a better life. Okay?
Yes, thank you. Yes, thank you.
I want you to stay on the line. I'm going to ask Monique to write down your real name, and she's going to bring right away so that Nuri can place inside of the holy oil.
Okay.
Did I help you?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Stay on the line, and very soon we are going to hear a beautiful story from you, okay?
Okay, okay.
God bless you. Have a good one. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
We are going to watch now the story of Becky. Several times she tried to kill herself, but she's now free from the pressure, from all evil, and she has a beautiful story to share with us.
Hi, my name is Becky Adebayo. I'm 53 years old, and my battle with depression started when I was between 13 and 15. That was when I had my first suicide attempt. I took pills. I was young. I didn't understand that it was depression. All I understood is I just was not happy. I didn't like myself. I went to the doctor, and they diagnosed me with depression, bipolar, put me on medication, and the medication just really made it worse. Extreme fatigue, no energy, no conversation, you don't want to talk, you don't want to see anybody, crazy thoughts of killing yourself. And the thought that was in my head and in most people's head is when you want to kill yourself, you're thinking and believing that it's better for everybody that you're dead. So I dealt with that for years, and also I had anxiety. I was nervous and I was timid and I was embarrassed and I was scared, and I can't explain why. I had thoughts of shooting myself. I wanted to die, but I didn't want to die in pain. So pills was my choice, because I'm like, let me take the pills. It'll put me to sleep. I won't wake up anymore. Or it'll give me a heart attack and die. Never works. And then I was labeled crazy. Some of my family members would say, oh, Becky, she's just crazy. And that just made me more depressed, because I'm like, in myself, I know I'm not crazy. There's something that I can't handle, that I can't fix. So when I was called crazy, it made me worse. I used to throw things, break things, curse people, curse you out. Everybody, kids, everybody. I mean, I was just wild. I lost a lot of jobs like that because I just couldn't function. I just couldn't be around people. I got to know Universal Church from a best friend of mine. She invited me. And the first time I came, I'm here now still. It's just the way the service was projected. It was just different. It was real. I've been to maybe about 6 different churches where I was there for some years, and I never changed. Nothing ever changed. Since coming to the Universal Church today, I'm happy, I'm at peace. I can handle things a lot more than I could years ago. Because when I was in that depression, I didn't have a future. So I'm happy now. The importance of having the Holy Spirit in my life is I have peace, is number one. I can think clearly. I can respond rationally with the Holy Spirit. I can handle different attitudes, you know, that may come from whoever. I have a mind and a conviction. The Holy Spirit gives you a conviction that keeps you from doing wrong things. And what I have now, people see it. They see that Becky's different. Friends and families, I've been told, oh, you are different. Yes, because I have the Holy Spirit. I have the presence of God.
Every time she'll get in depression, you can tell because she'll go to the room and she'll close her door. She wouldn't answer doors. And sometimes she would threaten to take pills. When she gets angry, it wasn't just a normal anger. She would stay angry. She would take it out on other people. It was things that she would destroy in the house, like as far as setting the couch on fire. She's not as depressed. And the anger issues that she had, she doesn't have the anger issues or like the bipolar issues. She's been off her medicine for years, and without the medicine, you know, she's been involved with the church. So I feel that because it is the Holy Spirit, she's been off the medicine for so long that they put you on to fix the problem. But there's, you know, she's not on medicine and the problem is not there anymore. The changes that I saw in my mom, when she started coming to the Universal Church, encouraged me to go to the Universal Church.
If there is anybody out there and you have felt the way I've described, whether you're a man or a woman, whatever you've been through, you should know whatever you've been through, rape, a bad marriage, molestation, drugs, whatever your issue is, there is a help. But at the Universal Church, they open their arms to you. And it doesn't matter what, they don't judge. All they want to do is bring you in and fight with you. So I urge you to please find a Universal Church that's near you and just go.
Suicide continues to be an epidemic in the United States. For various reasons, people have felt more inclined than ever to take their lives. Perhaps the pressure of life, such as making ends meet and paying bills and debts, has pushed you to the brink. Maybe you have been the victim of a bully and have no clue on how to handle it. Or maybe suicide is something that has been occurring in your family from generation to generation. Although the number of suicides fell from 47,511 in 2019 to 44,834 in 2020, it still was the 12th leading cause of death in the country. And since 2000, the rates of suicide have had a steady increase overall. Many people continue to feel as if the only way to escape all their problems is to commit suicide. Maybe you have struggled with suicidal thoughts as well. But stop right there. We are here to tell you that although you have been suffering, there is a way out. On Sunday, May 16th at 10 a.m. will be the Say No to Suicide event at every Universal Church. If you or someone you know has been struggling with suicidal thoughts, we invite you to come as you are to the Universal Church, where you won't be judged. There will be messages full of inspiration and strong prayers of deliverance to defeat all feelings of suicide that you may be dealing with. Life is worth living. It's time to say no to suicide and begin the life you always were meant to live. For the location nearest you, call 1-888-332-4141. That's 1-888-332-4141.
The day is tomorrow. The reason why you want to take your life is because you are tired of suffering, tired of troubles, setbacks. That's why you want to take your life. That was the situation of this young lady, Leslie. For multiple times, she tried to kill herself. Multiple times. She did not want to live anymore. But today she's very much alive and she's going to share her story with us. Take the life that you do not want. Hey, look here. Take this life that you do not want. Bring it to us tomorrow. At every Universal Church, we are going to take care of you. I know you. I know you. I know that you are tired of suffering. Actually, you are watching TV non-stop. Many televangelists, many pastors. You have not found what you want. Perhaps you are watching the Christian religious channels. because you want to find the comfort to your soul. You have not found. I know you, and I know what you want. You want to stop suffering. Therefore, tomorrow, Sunday, at every Universal Church, is your chance to have a better life.
There are moments when we feel completely alone, even when we are surrounded by people, to the point of screaming, crying, and hiding from everything and everyone as if something suffocates and oppresses us. It is at these times that we need to know who we have. In the Universal Church, people are willing to hear and guide you in any situation through this phone number, 1-888-332-4141. You can call us right now. You will not hear an answering machine, but someone who is going to help you spiritually. A simple word can make all the difference.
One simple word can make all the difference in your life. Those of you who are watching us and you haven't called, you can feel free to pick up the phone and call us just as Xavier did. He called ask and prayer for his finance, also for good health. Xavier, your name is here inside of the holy oil. We have Mrs. Ruth. She is asking on behalf of a loved one who was recently in a car accident, wants this person to have a speedy recovery. And we have Rashawn, who has been battling with addiction, has been battling with family problems and suicidal thoughts. Rashawn, your name is here inside of the holy oil, and we will be praying for you. We also have Miss Thelma. She wants the generational curse in her family to be broken. She sent us her prayer request through text message from Richmond. Mrs. Thelma, we will be praying for you. And those of you who are watching us, you want to do exactly as Miss Thelma did. You can send your prayer request through text message. That number is 1-888-312-4141. Or you can call the helpline to speak one of the counselors. But right now, let us go to Leslie's highlights and have a preview of just what she went through in life.
There was a lot of domestic violence. My dad, he had addictions to drugs. He would always drink. So I suffered in silence ever since I was 15. Actually, I got married, and in those 3 years, everything worsened. That's when I tried to commit suicide. I tried drowning myself. I tried taking pills so I would never wake up again. And I would always ask why. Like, why is it that I keep waking up again the next day?
Hey, stay over there. Do not go away, because she has much more to tell us. Let me go to the line. I have Mr. David from Florida. Hello.
Hi. Hi, Bishop.
Mr. David, tell me, how can I be of help today?
Yes, I've been feeling very, like hopeless, and, you know, just like life isn't what I thought it would be, you know. Every like dream I had, you know, I feel like I'm living a life where nothing can go right. You know, I just, everything I try to do doesn't turn out the way that I want it to. I'm just going through the motions every day of life. I'm not like I used to. Like, I think about a future, you know, thinking about, you know, having a family, you know. Everything that can go wrong has gone wrong, so I've lost hope of just everything. I've lost hope in everything. I don't live to be happy. Oh, my future's gonna be good. I'm gonna have this. I'm gonna do these things. You know.
So, Mr. David, it is called. Let me describe. I heard you clearly. I heard about your situation, but let me describe you. You are a man living without expectations.
Yes.
You live a life without expectation, right?
Yes, yes. That's the way I'm living now. I don't, you know, because I've tried so many things and nothing has worked. You know, every time I try to do something, it's like the whole, you know, like everything, every attack of the enemy comes at me.
Let me show to you this Bible verse which says, that God does not change his mind. God is not a man that he should lie. See what is written in the scripture. God is not a man that he should lie. God is not a son of man that he should repent. So, Mr. David, what God has promised to you will come to pass. He never fails. He has never given up on you. What is happening is that you are under a spiritual attack. This is it. You are under a spiritual attack. The evil spirits are attacking you so badly attacking you. That's why you gave up in life.
Yes. Yes, I agree. I've given up. I'm just going through the day, without, no aspiration of a future or anything. I'm just like, I've given up on my dreams.
Scripture that says, my crew will help me on that, but there is the script which says, I waited, I hoped for good, and evil came. This is what is happening to you. You expect good or you want good, only evil comes to you.
Yes.
Did you ever had any suicidal thoughts?
Yes, I've had them. And the only reason why I haven't gone through with it is because, I've known God most of my life. I believe, I've always been a spiritual, seeking God. So I know that's not the right thing to do. But I had a friend who did that. And I invited him to church, and he was a real good friend, and he took his life,
How long ago? That was
a long time ago. It was a long time ago, but he was a good friend.
But
and he had
your friend.
He took his life.
Your friend took his life.
Yeah.
Okay. The same evil that took his life, because Satan is a killer. Satan came to kill.
Yes.
The same evil that took his life is the same one that is telling you, kill yourself, take your life, kill yourself, take your life. But I say to you, sir, life is worth living. This Bible verse shows your situation. When I looked for good, evil came to me. And when I waited, light, then came darkness. That is exactly your situation. That is exactly what is happening to you. However, God will bring good and remove evil. God will bring light and remove darkness from your life. Okay?
Amen, amen. Yes.
I will be praying for you, and your situation is going to change.
Amen, amen. Thank you, Bishop.
I have a crew over there in Florida, and I'm going to pass your information for the pastors. They are going to follow up with you. Your life is going to change.
Amen.
Okay?
Amen. Thank you, Pastor. Thank you, Bishop. Thank you.
Stay on the line for me. Do not hang up yet.
Okay.
Monique is going to get more information from you.
Okay. Thank you so much, Pastor. Thank you.
You are welcome. Tomorrow, Sunday, at Every Universal Church, if you are just like Mr. David, come to see us. Job, in the Bible, said he was waiting for good, but evil came to him. When I waited for light, darkness came to me. This is what is happening to you. Darkness came, evil came, misery came, poverty came, and that's why you want to take your life. Let me show to you that suicide comes from the evil spirit. It is a sign of a spiritual attacks. Stay with me. Put your remote control aside. You are not going to need the remote control for now. You are going to stay here with me on the TV. Take your remote control. I'm talking to you. You have it in your hand. You have the channel position that you want to move to the news, to the movies. No, no. Put your remote aside. Stay here where you are. Watch me and see now how does the evil spirit works in one's mind to kill, steal, and destroy.
Suicidal thoughts. Hopelessness, despair, and an overwhelming sense that the pain of living is just too much to bear. Common feelings that leads to suicidal thoughts. The normal healthy reaction of protection from danger is overridden, and the person becomes obsessed with the idea of ending his or her life in order to find peace. Approximately 30,000 suicide deaths occur every year in the U.S. Every 3 seconds, someone under the age of 18 commits suicide worldwide. That constant inner voice convincing them that they are worthless pushes them over the edge. The fact that the person has suicidal thoughts is not signified that he is bad or evil, or even that he wants to have it. What they do signify is that a person is under a very serious spiritual attack. Jesus said the thief comes only to steal, kill, and destroy. Suicidal thoughts are a clear sign of the presence of evil spirits.
So the evil spirit is the one confusing your mind. You do not have a mental problem. Say no to suicide. Say no to these thoughts and come out of this situation. You do not need a rope. You do not need pills. You don't need to take your life. Your life can be transformed. Leslie had this in mind. I'll take my life. I'll kill myself. But Nori, Leslie has found hope. The evil darkness that were upon her life was removed. She's very much alive.
Yes, and those who are watching right now, they can also and will find hope. All they need to do is to pick up the phone and give us a call. There are many people who are calling right now. So you can call. You will speak to a live person. You won't be prompted to many different options. We have Mr. David. I did write down his name as he was speaking with Bishop Joshua. Mr. David, your name I'm placing here inside of the holy oil. We will be praying for you. We have Angela from Brooklyn, New York. She is asking prayer for complete and total healing in her body. And we have Mrs. Beverly. She is asking prayer for good health, for deliverance, and her finances. Ms. Beverly and those mentioned, your names are here inside of the holy oil. Mr. Harold, he sent us a text message asking prayer on behalf of his niece who is in the hospital in critical condition with a ruptured hernia. Mr. Harold, we will be praying for you and for your niece as well. Those of you who are watching us, you can do exactly the same as Mr. Harold did. You can give us a call. You can send your prayer request through text message because help is at hand. It's just a phone call away. But right now, let us go to Leslie's story and see how she overcame, because she faced depression, multiple suicide attempts, and was addicted to drinking and smoking. But her life today is completely transformed.
My name is Leslie, and I'm 29 years old. And ever since I was 15 years old, I noticed I had depression. It all started with the problems that I had at home. That there was a lot of domestic violence. My dad was, he had addictions to drugs, he would always drink. So I suffered in silence ever since I was 15. And I didn't know how to deal with that. So I started drinking. I started going out to parties. I started smoking, and I had the wrong type of friends. And ever since then, I didn't notice who I was anymore. Like, I lost the sense of who I was. I ended up getting into a relationship. I actually ended up getting married because I thought that the problems would go away. I thought that depression would go away, the suicidal thoughts that I had. I thought the drinking would stop. And actually, I got married, and in those 3 years, everything worsened. That's when I tried to commit suicide. I tried drowning myself. I tried taking pills so I would never wake up again. And I would always ask why, like, why is it that I keep waking up again the next day? And I even questioned if God even existed, because I always wondered, like, okay, well, if God was really real, like, why am I going through the problems I went through? Why would I see the things that I saw at home? And my mom was actually going to church since I was 8, and I decided I didn't want to go because I didn't believe in it. I would see the testimonies. I'd be like, okay, well, If that's happening to other people, why am I not good enough to receive that blessing in my life? My ex-husband at the time, he ended up cheating on me. And that's where I hit, like, you know, the bottom. Like, I just, like, you know what? I'm not gonna live, you know, I don't wanna live anymore. I don't wanna be in this world anymore. And that's when I told my mom, you know, bring me to church. I got so tired of the problems. I got so tired of the depression. I got so tired of, there were moments that the addictions would stop. And I was like, okay, I have control. But in reality, it never did. So this time I gave myself entirely. I challenged God, telling God, you know what? If you're real, if you're truly real, because I've never had a full conversation with you, I don't know who you are, but if you change my life, I'll never leave your presence ever again. And that's what God did. And these 3 years, I could never say that I am, you know, the person I was 3 years ago. So I was delivered from the addictions. I no longer had insomnia. I could sleep well at night, which was the first thing that ever happened. That first week, I was able to sleep perfectly. And it was something that I couldn't do in the past years. Like, it was something amazing. I was happy, and I was like, okay, but there's something still missing. You know, I don't have that one thing that pastor was taught, gave me the word. And he said, you know, you're not of God if you don't have the Holy Spirit. And I was like, wait. And then as I was at that moment, I was like, that's what I'm missing. I fasted, I prayed, I did so much that I gave myself fully. And that it was on a Wednesday that I received the Holy Spirit. And I remember it was right there that I knew that I wasn't alone anymore, that God was with me. And I had a desire to tell everybody, you know, like, we need the Holy Spirit. Like, that, you know, that's the one thing that's missing. No, today, there's no addictions. I have no cravings for no drugs. I can sleep well at night. I'm happy. Like, there's a happiness within me that is incomparable to anything. Like, I know that every single fight, every single tear that I ever shed throughout, you know, those years that I didn't know God was worth it, because I had to go through it to know who God is truly. And I will never leave the presence of God. If right now you're not sure if God's gonna truly change your life, I'm a living testimony of that. You know, don't wait till tomorrow, because you don't know if today's your last day. And don't wait till, like, the last moment where you're truly suffering. Like, give it a chance. It's not what God can offer you, is because everything you need is the Holy Spirit, because it's through the Holy Spirit that it's all worth it.
Josh took his own life when he was about 20 years old. It was his second attempt.
Just 4 days before his 13th birthday, Brad and April Huntsable's son, Hayden, died by suicide.
There is a heartbreaking loss in the front lines of this fight. A well-known ER doctor here in New York who battled to save the lives of so many others. Her family now says she has taken her own life.
Three people are dead after a fatal fire in New Jersey. Was it a murder-suicide? That is the question investigators in Wayne are trying to answer.
Say no to suicide. Put an end to your problems, not to your life.
And as I was starting to get the courage to, you know, prepare to actually hang myself, I don't exactly remember what happened, but somebody walked into my room, and in that moment, like, I kind of snapped out of it. I took an action to come back to church, and even though I didn't want to be in church, but I knew, you know, right from wrong. I knew that what I was living was wrong, and I knew that my response, my answer would be going back to church, would be seeking God. I found out that day that the only person I needed to accept me was Jesus. And that's when I received his spirit, and I was never the same person again. So I am happy. I'm a person who is very happy. I want to live. I do not want to end. But if I can, I'd like to live many more years.
We will help you. Sunday, May 16th at 10 a.m., we will be teaching you how to put an end to suicidal thoughts at a Universal Church near you.
You are going to receive the help that you need. Maybe you say, I'm not suicidal. My daughter is. My son is. My mother, my husband is. So then bring this person tomorrow to see us. Do not be added, included to the suicidal rate. No, you cannot be part of the statistic. You have to overcome in life. And you are going to overcome. I want you to prepare one cup of water, because in a few we are going to pray. Lord, His name is to be placed inside of the holy oil. You can call, you can text, because we are available.
That's correct, Bishop Joshua. We have Mr. Tony all the way from West Virginia. He is asking prayer for his finances and for healing. Mr. Tony, your name is here inside of the holy oil. We have Alan. He is asking prayer for deliverance. He wants to overcome anxiety, suicidal thoughts, and depression. We have Mr. Ethel, who is asking prayer for his family, for his grandchildren, and we also have Peyton, who wants to be set free from drug addiction and also wants the family to be blessed. Peyton, your name is here inside of the holy oil, and we will be praying for all of you. The line is open. The helpline is available. The team of faith is there ready to answer your call. The number that you can dial, 1-888-332-4141. If you're watching us through social media, whether it's through Facebook, through YouTube, leave your prayer request on the comments below. But take the link, share with a friend, share with a loved one. And as Bishop Joshua said, if you haven't done so, prepare your cup of water, your glass of water, and set it close to your television, because before the end of the program, he'll be praying for all of you.
You go through life working and working, but you never see success. Your bank account is always in the negative. The money you work so hard for seems to just disappear into thin air. Bills are piling up, and bill collectors are always knocking on your door. You feel like there's no way out of this misery. Now is the moment of prosperity for you who need a financial miracle. God, the creator of heaven and earth, will bless and prosper you. When you sow your seed, you are planting a miracle to reap a miracle. Moment of prosperity for a financial miracle.
One of the problems that causes depression and suicide is the problem that leads a person to take his life. Many take their lives due to a financial problem. Many take their lives due to a financial failure, bankruptcy. You have lost your business. The car was repossessed. You are suicidal because you are now inside of a car, watching us on Facebook, on YouTube. You are inside of a motel, though you are not on vacation. You are suicidal. You really want to take your life. I say to you, you don't need to take your life to solve your problem. But God will solve your problems. You are going to be prosperous. The Lord said here, the thief does not come except to steal and to kill and to destroy. But he also said, I have come that they may have life. He never said suicide, death. He said life. He came to give you life, and that they may have life more abundantly. The Lord wants to give you life more abundantly. Therefore, do not panic. Do not try to kill yourself. Financially speaking, you want to kill yourself, to take your life. Hey, let me talk to you. Let me have a conversation, me and you. Forget about others. There are many other people watching me, right? Yes, I know. But let me talk to you. I want to talk to you. You who are saying to me, I lost my job, my company, my car, no money for the insurance, no money to buy medication. I lost my business, and that's why I want to take my life. Well, the thief came to kill, but he said, I came to give you life, not death, not suicide. Sow a seed right now into this ministry. The Lord is going to bless you. Because of this financial problem, as they say, I have a rope in my neck. Because of this situation, you have the rope. It is there already. You have put it there. You have the chair. You have the chair, you want to climb and you want to hang yourself. Don't do that. I know you already have a rope. Financially speaking, you have a rope in your neck. However, this is what you are going to do. You are not going to kill yourself. You are going to sow a seed. God will prosper you, and you are going to have much more to give to the Lord. Much more. You are going to have money to pay your debts, to pay your bills, to buy what you want, because prosperity gives you power. That's my number for the seed. 1-888-691-2291. Go ahead, call this number, sow the seed that will empower you and bless your life. Mrs. Rose sowed the seed into this ministry. The Lord prospered her. See what was done in her life.
My name is Rose Juma. I'm 55 years old. So my brother was sick for COVID since January the 1st of 2021 when he was taken to the hospital. So when he was healed and was supposed to be released from the hospital, he was being held in the hospital because of the bill. The bill was $10,000, and we didn't know how to get that $10,000. The insurance agreed that approved only $8,000, so we didn't know where to get the $2,000 difference. And I sowed a seed towards that, came to the church, took an envelope, sowed a seed, prayed by faith that that seed that I'd given was for this situation. They called me and said, my brother is home. And so we were like, what happened? How did you guys get the 2000? And they said, no. He asked the doctor just released him, and he asked the doctor, what about the 2000 difference? And the doctor said, well, they will square that between the hospital and the insurance company. We were so joyous. We were just thanking God for his faithfulness towards our cry to him and our prayers, and he answered our prayers. Neither of us had the 2000. My brothers and sisters, all of us together, we did not have the 2000 that was needed. But what I had, I sowed it all. God just answered the prayers. So what I can tell the people is, whatever you have, if you have a problem, and it's not enough to solve your problems, God is the source. The fact that I sowed what I have, which was not enough to pay for the bill, God gave us much more and just released him, gave him help. So sowing seed is very important.
Sow your seed today and reap the blessings of God in your life as it is written. Give, and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over will be put into your bosom. For with the same measure that you use, it will be measured back to you. To all the viewers of the Showdown of Faith on Living Faith, you have two different ways in which you can sow your seed. By calling us at 1-888-691-2291. Our assistants are ready to answer your call and guide you through the process of sowing your seed. By mail, send your check or money order under the name of the Universal Church to 7075 Southwest Freeway, Houston, Texas, 77074.
Right now, you can continue to call in to sow your seed, and in just a few, I'll show you what your seed has allowed us to do for the community here in Houston. But before, I do have more names to be placed here inside of the holy oil. We have Mrs. Donna. She is asking prayer for her entire family. She even left their names so it can be placed here inside of the holy oil. We have Sydney, who is asking prayer for deliverance, who wants to be set free from depression and suicidal thoughts. We also have Natasha, who is asking prayer for good health. She wants to be healed from high blood pressure, glaucoma, and she wants her family to be blessed and protected. Natasha, your name is here inside of the holy oil. We will be praying for you as well. But right now, I want you to see for yourself what your seed, what your donations has enabled us to do for the community.
The Universal Church is always ready and willing to help the community in all different types of ways.
In Houston, Texas, the Unisocial, in collaboration with the UBB Ministries, joined the Houston Police Department, the District Council member, Edward Pollard, local food vendors, and volunteers to facilitate a special event for the community. Local residents had the opportunity to get educated on their rights as citizens and find out how they can use their rights to help protect the community. They were also given a chance to get the COVID vaccine. Food assistance was also offered to attendees and their families. Most importantly, they received prayer and a special word of faith from the pastors and bishops from the Universal Church. The Unisocial is interested in the well-being of the community and is pursuing more ways to meet their mission of reaching out to those in need.
This is the moment to talk to the one that never changed his mind. Men lies. Men change their minds, their promises. But the scripture says, God is not a man. No, he is not. That he should lie. Nor a son of man that he should repent. What he promised, he is able to fulfill it. I invite you to pray with me. I will pray for you. Get your cup of water or a glass of water, a bottle of water. Let us pray together. And the one that never changed his mind will bless you.
Prayer is our communication with God. You watched the testimonies. You heard the word. But now, please, close your eyes and prepare for the moment of prayer.
In life we have so much pain. Know everything.
Please, close your eyes. Oh God Almighty, my God, my Father, I know you are with me because I am with you. I don't pray as a pastor, a preacher, a bishop. I pray as your son. I am talking to my Father. And when I speak to you, I know that you can listen to me. I am a father. If my children call, asking for help, I will be there for them, because I am their Father. Lord, you are our Heavenly Father. Come quickly to hear us. Come quickly to hear our prayers. To you I pray, O Lord. I call upon your name knowing that your ears are opened. Visit now this person that is suicidal. This person like Mr. David, living without expectation, living without meaning. My Lord Jesus, transform his life. Transform the life of this mother whose son is suicidal. And suicide has been a curse in this family. Many or some family members already took their lives. And this person hears a voice say, you are the next. Lord Jesus, solve the problem of this person. And even though she will hear this voice killing herself, she's not going to do it. Because you are not a man. You are not a human being. You should not lie or change your mind. What you have promised, you are able to fulfill. Lord Jesus, bless this cup of water. When this person drink of this water, let it be a holy remedy. I consecrate and I bless in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Praise God. Amen. you are going to drink of this water. And you are going to receive peace inside of your soul. Once again, I tell you, you don't need to take your life to solve your problem. The Lord has solved your problem. And I tell you, Jesus is waiting for you. He has his arms wide open, waiting for you. If nobody wants your life, not even yourself, take the life you don't want, bring it to the Lord. He's going to take your life and transform you. Drink this water, it is blessed.
With open arms, Jesus is waiting.
Come as you are.
Come as you are.
Thou hesitate.
Don't hesitate.
He holds for you.
Ooh.
All that you need.
All that you need.
Come as you are. It's time to breathe free.
Universal Living Faith Network, where faith is alive. Thought of the day. Therefore, whatever you want men to do to you, do also to them, for this is the law and the prophets. Do for others what you'd like them to do for you. Don't change the channel. We will be right back with more of the Showdown of Faith.
When a woman gives birth, the sweetest sound to her ears is her newborn baby's cry. She can never forget the first time she hears his voice. Everyone in that delivery room celebrates the beautiful sound. Beautiful. Because it's a sign of life. But as a child grows, its cry signifies hunger, pain, or an unmet need. A cry is like an alarm demanding a mother's urgent help. It is time for you to act, O Lord, for they have regarded your law as void. When she hears her child's cry, a mother instinctively knows it's time to act. And when God, our Father, hears his people crying out with an active faith, he also knows that it's time to act. Evil forces have been lying to God's people, treating God's word as worthless and void. How can we stand by and allow these lies to take hold of us? It's time for God to act, and he is ready to remove the lies and pain from our lives. Yet we need to act our faith first by standing upon this promise and determining that it will come true for us. Our cry of pain to God can transform into a shout of joy for the many blessings we receive. It becomes a sign of new life. Do whatever it takes to show the world that God is alive, that his words are true, and that the lies and shame are gone. God is ready to act. Are you?
If you live far from a universal church or have no church of your own, you are more than welcome to join the virtual church. Prayers.
It can't be one more church service. No, Lord. The lives of these people have to change.
The Lord's Supper taken every month.
Eat the body of Jesus Christ.
Testimonies.
I no longer have kidney problems.
I've been free of pain meds for about two and a half weeks now, and I was on them every day.
So like I said, I received the Holy Spirit. I've been, you know, in church all my life, but it's just different here. The Spirit is so different.
Words of faith.
You have a situation that has been too strong in your family. You have a disease in your body that has been too strong for you. Fine, but it's not stronger than God.
Inspirational songs.
Hey, behold, he comes.
Shining like the sun.
As the trumpets go, lift your voice. Let's go, Miss Tiffany.
Join the virtual church today so that you can reconnect with God. You are watching The Showdown of Faith with Bishop Joshua Fonseca here on the Living Faith Network.
And we're back with more Showdown of Faith, a program of less talk and more power. I do have more names of those who are continuing to call the program asking for prayer. We have Heidi. She is asking prayer for deliverance to be set free from evil and from hatred. Heidi, your name is here inside of the holy oil. We have Angela. She is asking prayer for complete and total healing in her body. And we also have Mrs. Cheryl. She is asking prayer for all areas of her life. She feels as if her life is stuck and she wants this situation to change. Ms. Cheryl and those mentioned, your names are here inside of the holy oil, and we will be praying for you. The number to the helpline, 1-888-332-4141. If you want to send your prayer request through text message, that number is 1-888-312-4141. And if you're watching us through Facebook, through YouTube, leave your prayer request on the comments below, but take the link and share with a loved one so they can also tune into the Showdown of Faith and be blessed. And before the end of the program, Bishop Joshua will be praying for all of you.
For 16 years, she was depressed and suicidal. She constantly cut herself and was under suicide watch in the psychiatric ward. But now her life has changed. She will never again face these problems.
What is your name?
My name is Norman Ateyes.
Miss Norman, when you came into this church, you had a problem that was again and again happening in your love life. What was that?
For the past 16 years, I was depressed and suicidal. And I've been married 3 times. The first marriage was...
How many times?
3 times. The first one, he tried to attack me and my son with the...
Hold on, please. Baby, you don't know what it is. I don't know. She was married once, divorced. Twice, divorced. The third time, another divorce. We have to say what? We have to say never again. You said three times. Tell me, please, the reason of these three divorces.
They made me feel that I wasn't worth it. The only thing that I turned into is commit suicide.
The first one, what happened?
He pulled a gun at me and my son. And I figured that I can find any other man because I only can have one child, which I only have one child. He was my
marriage. The second marriage, what happened?
He was abusive. He made me feel belittled, that I wasn't worth it at all. And that's when I committed suicide, tried to kill myself.
The third divorce.
He went out on me, started doing drugs, and I wasn't going to have that at all in my life. I was tired of that. So many times that I suffered, that's why I turned into committing suicide. Every time I cut myself, I saw the blood. I felt smooth and comforting because I was.
Hold on. You see the marks of, this is not a Photoshop. This is her arms. You said when you saw the blood, what happened?
I felt comforting, smooth.
Why? Why? I'll tell you the reason why. When a person is depressed and cut himself, as she said, you see the blood, you feel good because you are trying to ease the pain of the soul, torturing the flesh. The suicidals, those who cut themselves, they are trying to ease the soul, the pain in the soul. Is that right?
Yes, sir, I did. I want to be out. And the more I did it, the more I felt comfortable, until one day, one morning, I turned on the TV and I saw you preaching. And as soon as I turned around again, I felt that you knew me and I felt comfortable because you knew what was I going through. So that day you said, look at the number on the screen and called, which I called.
By coming to this ministry, Ms. Norma, how is your life? What has God done for you?
I have changed, no more depressed. I don't even think about suicide. I'm in peace and I love myself and I love this world.
Did you have an addiction?
No, I was an alcoholic. I drank a lot because I used the beer bottles to cut myself. And then once I cut myself, they took me to the hospital. Then I was so upset because I'd attempted to kill myself. So I did it again. I did alcohol poisoning. They took me back to the hospital. They pumped the alcohol out. And the doctor recognized me, that this is the second time they saw me. They sent me to a psychiatric ward. They evaluated me. They gave me 6 or 7 pills to help me calm down. But no, that was not working until I found out about this church. I found the right person when she came in December to propose. He proposed with my son. He wants to marry me. My life is good. My family's contempt, but I really appreciate that God is the greatest gift they gave me because He gives me life. He's the one who showed the light so I can help somebody do the same thing. But I feel, that's how I feel.
Never again suffering.
No, no more.
No more.
No more at all.
Great is your faith. God bless you.
Norma will never again face these problems. Join us at the Universal Church near you so that you can also say never again.
Yes, his body was covered with leprosy, and that man Naaman, he was a captain. He had a high position in the army, but under his uniform, under his clothing, there was leprosy, a contagious disease that was eating his flesh, his skin, his bones. But a man of God told him, go to the water, the Jordan River, and wash yourself 7 times. He did dip himself once, twice, 3 times, 5, 6 times, nothing happened. But on the 7th time, he came out of the water and his flesh was clean as a young boy. His flesh was restored. Hey, God wants to restore your health. wants to take you out of this disease, this infirmity. That's why I have here this water. And I am going to send this water to you. This is the spiritual treatment.
How long were you in a coma for?
For weeks.
For weeks. I mean, after you woke up, what did the doctor say?
Yeah, they weren't looking for me to make it. They gave up on me.
The pastor came to pray for me. I don't even know him coming, but he came and prayed for me.
And now you can see here James' mother. Miss, what's your name?
Geneva Dell.
Miss Geneva, then you were taking the water for your son.
I was taking the water, giving it to him every morning, every noon, every night.
After the coma, nursing home, and now you're here.
I'm walking without the cane.
I'm here to give testimony regarding my son. He was in ICU for 2.5 months in life support. And it got to the point that he got really worse. And the doctor came and tell me that it was nothing to do. The cup where they put the water to give him the medication, so they had to flush it through the tube. So I used my blessing water, and I used all my faith.
After that miracle happened, I knew it was time for a change. I gave my life to the Lord, and here I am today.
Her daughter was in critical condition due to severe kidney problems. She was in the ICU.
Say, my Lord Jesus, right here,
right here,
and right now,
and right now,
I repent of all my sins. I came here to heal her, but above it else, to save her.
Shortly after, a miracle occurred. Salita was recovering, so much so that she came to the church with her family.
Hi, Bishop Brewer. Thank you for coming to see me. Well, I was in a hospital. That was me then. This is me now.
Name ahead. Seven water. Let me say, seven times he dipped himself. This is the miracle water, the spiritual treatment. Call this number. Hey, hey, call me now. 1-888-691-2291. Call this number, request this water. I am going to pray here with the pastors.
Those of you who would like to request the spiritual treatment water and receive it there where you are, you have two options on how you can do so. The first option is by calling the line to sow the seed, that number 1-888-691-2291. You'll speak with one of the counselors. They will guide you step by step on how to do so. When you do call in sowing your seed towards one of the inspirational books, just like this one here, it's called Our Bread for 365 Days. It has a Bible verse for each and every day of the year and a strong message of faith to empower you, to inspire you, and to help you grow spiritually. And along with it, free of charge, you receive the spiritual treatment water. The other option that you do have is to write a letter to Bishop Joshua requesting for the spiritual treatment, but you can include your prayer request or even the names of your loved ones from the oldest down to the youngest. And when sending in this letter along with a donation, whether it's a check or money order, always make sure that it is written under the Universal Church. For security purposes, you never want to leave the check or money order in blank, but under the Universal Church, and you never want to send in cash. And the address that you can post it to, 7075 Southwest Freeway, Houston, Texas, 77074. And those are the ways, the options that you have to request the spiritual treatment water and receive it there at your doorstep.
Supernatural faith. Obedience. Make miracles possible. All things are possible for those who believe.
Miss Dolores, did you drink the water?
I drank the water, but the story is about my grandson. I gave her the water.
You gave the water to who?
This one.
To your grandson?
The grandson.
He had an accident?
Yes.
Mommy, what was the problem with your son?
My son, Denzel, he was playing basketball. He hit his head. He had two seizures, and he was bleeding from the head as well. And he came out of the coma in one day, and the next day the doctor said he had stage 6 kidney failure, that his kidneys was failing.
So he had an accident, he fell?
Yes, and then they said he had kidney failure.
Mm-hmm.
Stage 6.
Stage 6.
Yes. It was about to shut down. They said it was failing. They wanted to know, did he have any type of health medical condition before? And he's never had any type of medical condition or any type of illness or anything. He was playing basketball and just hit his head, and everything just started to break down. And once when I gave him that water, oh.
So your mom say you gave it to her, to your daughter, the water to take to the hospital?
Yes. She asked me, did I have any water? I said, yes, I do. So when I gave him the water, her the water, for him to drink, in about 2 days, his kidneys start coming back up to normal.
After 2 days.
And he was drinking. He drank that water, okay?
He was drinking. How? You gave him the water in the hospital?
Yes.
We see the picture, that picture he was inside of the hospital.
That's him.
Did you remember your mom gave you the holy water?
Yes.
Okay. So, mom, you gave him the water?
I gave him the water. I knew that the water would, with my faith, that water was going to work. And once when I gave him that water, it went down to a 5, then it went down to a 4.
It just went all the way down until I left, like in a week.
1 week?
Yeah, 1 week.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel?
Feel good. Feel
good.
Back to normal.
So back to normal, and you are a happy mother today.
I'm just, God is so good. And when I say good, he is great.
He is.
He is great.
So mom, you happy as well?
Yes, and thank God for the water.
Amen.
I believe in it.
You believe in it?
Yes, I do.
Great is your faith. God bless you.
Supernatural faith. Obedience. Make miracles possible. All things are possible for those who believe.
Everything is possible. This mother, grandmother, they are happy because the young man, he was about to die. You just saw his story. There was an accident, a tragedy. He was dying in the hospital, in coma, kidney failure. But you know, this mother used the water, went inside of the hospital with the water. He drank the water. Question, don't you think that in the hospital they have water? They do have water, don't they? Was he drinking water? Maybe. But this water that was taken was the holy anointing water. You are going to watch the case of Miss LaToya in a few. She also drank the water. These people saw us on the TV. As Miss LaToya says, she was watching a testimony and she saw somebody that she knew testify. Then she thought, it is not just a scheme, it is real. She came to us, drank the water. You are going to see in a few for her result. You can call us right now. The number to call is 1-888-332-4141. Nori, let us help this person that wants to be anonymous. Hello?
Yeah.
Hello?
Hello. Yes, sir.
Hello, sir. Tell me, what is your problem? How can we help you?
Sir, I'm battling with loneliness, and I desire that the Lord would send me a helpmate. The Bible says it's not good for man to be alone, and I've been alone since 2005. And, you know, I'm just tired of being lonely, and depression sets in. And like I said, I've had 3 bad marriages. So, failed marriages, should I say. So, and then, of course, I've got some kids that I've lost some of my kids in the process, so it's been hard on me, sir.
How many kids do you have?
But it's, I have five kids.
Five kids. Of course, different mothers, right?
I've got four kids with my first wife and one on the side.
But you have tried three times to have a family, to have a good marriage, all three times failed.
And let me tell you something, sir.
Yes.
It is a pleasure to talk to you. I love talking to a man of God, and I think that you are, and I believe that you are. And I just wish God could turn my life around, completely around. I want to die a happy man, not a miserable man.
Yes.
Because I've seen people that died miserable, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
And I ask God to help me every day, and just like I say, it's not my will, but let his will be done.
Let me ask you a question. Sir, how old are you?
69.
69 years old. You have been through a lot in life, and you have
Absolutely. This
frustration in your love life. God has power to transform your life, to change this situation. As you already quoted, he said it's not good for a man to be alone. You need somebody, sir. Let me tell you something.
Absolutely.
You need somebody not to have a companion. Not just because you are 69 and you don't want to die miserable, but you need someone for the word of God to be fulfilled in your life. You need someone because his word must be fulfilled in your life. And above all, you deserve to be happy. It is your right.
Yes.
It is your right. Jesus came to give you life more abundantly. And this abundant life is not just related to money or prosperity, but abundance of love, abundance of peace, abundance of happiness, abundance of salvation. He wants to give you abundance.
Absolutely. You know, the Bible says it's not good to be alone. He's not only talking about mankind, woman also, you know. It's not good for her to be alone either.
No, it is not. The word of God is clear. You are right. God wants to make you happy. And I'm going to be praying for you so that God will bring to you the right person. Because if you receive the wrong person, it's going to be loneliness anyway. You don't need, you do not have time for any more attempts. You do not have time to try once again. This time, you need to have a person that will be with you till death do apart. Okay?
Yes, sir.
I want you to stay on the line. I'm going to ask Monique to get your name so that we can place your name inside of the holy oil. And God will prepare the blessing for you. No more loneliness, no more depression. Okay?
Absolutely.
Stay on the line for me, please. God bless you. If you say, I have the same problem, I am getting old, an old woman, an old man, I am alone, my family is not there for me, my children, I need a partner, a person that will come from the Lord. Let us pray together. Give him a call right now. By the way, on Sundays, we pray for the family in this church. A family that prays together stays together.
What have I done to deserve this?
Sometimes you wish you could just start all over. So many mistakes, so many poor choices.
You are just like your father.
You see no other way out but to settle for the life you've ended up with. Always in debt.
How did you end up picking up food and welfare?
Tired of being humiliated and hurt. Physically weakened by sickness and ill health. Your family repeating the same old mistakes that you made. Is it really possible to begin again? Could a new life really be waiting for you? Anyone who belongs to Christ has become a new person. The old life is gone. A new life has begun. This promise needs to come true in your own life, and it can all begin this Sunday at the Universal Church. Join us this Sunday at 10 a.m. 7075 Southwest Freeway, Houston, Texas, 77074. A new life is waiting for you. Supernatural faith. Obedience. Make miracles possible. All things are possible for those who believe.
My name is LaToy Scott.
Ms. LaToy, what did God do for you in this ministry?
I had an addiction for 34 years that I couldn't kick.
Addiction of what?
Marijuana.
Marijuana.
Yes. I had it pretty bad where I spent $500 to $700, close to $1,000 a week.
Really?
Yes. So I was depressed. I watched you for 2 days, but I noticed someone that I knew giving a testimony on your show.
So hold on. You're watching TV. And you saw somebody you knew.
Yes.
So then it was not some female rap, was not a scam.
No.
You saw a person on the TV that you knew.
Yes, that I had actually met a few months prior on TV.
Right.
Her testimony. And her testimony was my testimony. And just watching you and hearing you and drinking the water, it changed my life.
Jesus changed your life in which way?
Like I said, I kicked the addiction. My household changed. My business changed. It prospered. I'm doing very well now. My kids, my household is better.
Drinking the water, doing the chain of prayers.
Yes, and I'm here Monday, Wednesdays, Fridays, and Sundays.
Do you miss marijuana?
No, I don't.
Cravings?
No.
Free?
Free, totally free.
Supernatural faith. Obedience. Make miracles possible. All things are possible for those who believe.
That's right. Everything is possible for those who believe. This lady, she was watching me as you are now. LaToya was watching me as you are now. But she said, let me go to this church. Let me try what they say. She was on marijuana for long 35 years, depressed, spent all she had. But you know, she saw testimony of somebody she knew. She knew the life of the other lady who was testifying. And she said, it's better be true. It cannot be some female rap. And she came. Look at her smile. Look at her transformation. You can be the next one. Look at her. She was not like that ever. 35 years she was in marijuana, drinking. But now, her life has been transformed. Come to see us at the Universal Church. We are open every single day. Tomorrow, Sunday, we are going to be praying for you. 7 o'clock in the morning, 10 in the morning, and 3 in the afternoon, in the evening, 6 p.m. We are going to be there praying for you. That's my address. Houston, Texas, 7075 Southwest Freeway. This church is between Bel Air and Hillcroft. I am going to be there tomorrow praying for all of you. You are going to come into this place. It is your church home. Maybe you say, I have my own church. No. You don't have a church. You are the church. That's why you can come. Church can come to church, right? So then that's why you can come. 10 o'clock in the morning, I start the main service, and I finish the service before 12 noon. 7075 Southwest Freeway, Houston, Texas. I want to show to you the testimony of this gentleman. He also saw us in on the TV from Philadelphia. He saw us in Philadelphia, and now he came to our church in California. No more depression. God blessed him with a business. He drank the blessed water.
Supernatural faith. Obedience. Make miracles possible. All things are possible for those who believe.
My name is Martin Palmer.
Martin Palmer. Okay, how did you know about this church?
I found out about it through the Showdown of Faith up late one time. I was battling through depression, suicide, and you came on the TV. And I knew at that time I needed a strong prayer. And I had actually been seeking a strong prayer for a while. I went to several different churches, and for some reason, I wasn't able to get a strong prayer.
How many churches, more or less?
About four or five different churches.
Four or five different churches. You saw us on the TV. You came into this church. What did God do for you?
God has gave me a business. He's let me live out almost every dream of my life. He's helped me get here through my business.
What about depression?
The depression, that's absolutely gone. I enjoy every single day.
Did you drink the water?
Yes, sir.
Did it work?
Absolutely.
Great is your faith.
Supernatural faith. Obedience. Make miracles possible. All things are possible for those who believe.
If you'd like a spiritual treatment water packet to be sent to you, just follow these three simple steps. Step one, send a letter addressed to Bishop Joshua to ask for some spiritual treatment water to be mailed to you. Make sure to include a prayer request as well. Your letter and contact information will be kept private. Step two, make a donation. With a gift offering of $25 or more, a book will be specifically chosen and mailed to you from the Showdown of Faith bookshop along with your spiritual treatment water. Step three, follow the guidelines. Follow the guidelines on the back of the water packet about how you can use your faith in this practical way and see how God responds when we trust in His Word. Reach out to us and request your spiritual treatment water today.
You can continue to call in to request your spiritual treatment water or to have your name placed inside of the holy oil. Many people are continuing to call. You can call us 1-888-332-4141. You won't be prompted to many different options and you will not get the voicemail, but you will speak to a live person. We have Miss Roxanne from Connecticut. She is asking prayer for healing. She's losing strength to walk. She wants God to restore her health completely. Miss Roxanne, I'm placing your name here inside of the holy oil. We have Miss Joanne, who has been battling with many health problems. She wants good health. And we also have Mrs. Black. She is asking prayer on behalf of her son for him to be set free from depression. And she also wants healing for herself, Ms. Black. And those mentioned, your names are here inside of the holy oil. We do have Ms. Jane, who sent her prayer request through text message, asking prayer for her entire family. She left their names as well. She also asked for financial breakthrough. Mrs. Jane, we will be praying for you. If you would like to do as Ms. Jane did, send your prayer request through text message, that number 1-888-312-4141, because help is at hand and is just a phone call away.
You can find the Universal Church in all continents. Here's where you can find various locations in the United States. In Texas, 7075 Southwest Freeway, Houston, Texas 77074. In the Empire State of New York, 1091 Fulton Street, Brooklyn, New York 11238. In Alabama, 3795 Eastern Boulevard, Montgomery, Alabama, 36116. In the Golden State of California, 1900 West Alondra Boulevard, Compton, California, 90220. In Connecticut, 324 Madison Avenue, Bridgeport, Connecticut, 06604. In the first state of Delaware, 4101 North Market Street, Wilmington, Delaware, 19802. In Illinois, 345 West 95th Street, Chicago, Illinois, 60628. You can find the Universal Church in all continents. For our nearest location, call 1-888-332-4141. Or send us a text to 1-888-312-4141.
There are many things in life people put first. The job, the money, the spouse, the children. But what about God? He's the last one in their lives. God must be the first one in our lives. Consideration, reverence, trust, obedience, faithfulness. This is tithe. Tithe is like when we cut the first slice of the cake and offer to someone we consider the most important person. Like the firstborn. Like the first prayer in the morning. When you think of God before everything. Tithe is the first fruit of our harvest. The first fruit belongs to God. Seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you. Become a faithful tither. When you put God first, he also puts you first.
When you put God first, he also puts you first. But today, I want to talk about those who want to obey the Bible only in what pleases them. If they could, they would skip or even change, erase, delete. They would tear up the pages from the Bible, the things that they do not like. Jesus spoke about it when he here on Matthew 23, also 23, when the Lord Jesus said, "Oh, to you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you pay tithe of mint and anise and cumin, and have neglected the weightiest matter of the law, justice, mercy, and faith. This you ought to have done without leaving the others undone," which means that we have to do everything written in the scripture in the Bible. We cannot skip or do just what we like. What we dislike, we do not obey. They were given the tithes, but they were not obeying the law. Others think that because they obey the law, they don't need to pay their tithes. Actually, our worship to the Lord, our act of worship, must be complete, cannot be half. When you yourself, you become the tithe, you give the tithe, you return the tithe of the salary, a bonus, a money that you earn, that you receive, what is yours, but also you have this clean life before the Lord. A clean life. You do not do what is wrong to please others. You become the tithe. You pay the first 10%. As we always say, between brackets, you return what belongs to God. But also, you obey the law, justice, mercy, and faith. You do exactly what the Lord wants you to do. Be faithful to the Lord. Return to God exactly what is his. Do not omit anything. Do not leave anything undone. Just 10% does not please God. What pleases God is the first fruit, because you put God first, and secondly, your life, that is the tithe itself. You give the first 10%, you return it, but the 90% of your life is also His, which means your tithe is 100%. I'm not talking about the amount of money, but I'm talking about the surrender, your reverence, the fear of the Lord. Return to God what is His, but also give to Him your entire life. If you obey the voice of God and you want to return the tithe right now, you are going to call this number that will show to you right now on your screen. 1-888-691-2291. Write down this number. Maybe you do not have a tithe to return right now, but you keep this number. 1-888-691-2291. Call now to return your tithe.
I went to a car lot trying to get my credit up so I can get me a car. And they gave me this car and the trans went out. So who I went through to, what you want to call it, car notes. They told me to take it back to them and they got to give me another vehicle. So at this time, they gave me another vehicle. And I end up having an accident in that vehicle. That car didn't just last long. It was a 2002, I believe. A Taurus 2002. I end up being carless for a good 2 or 3 weeks. I'm gonna just say by October the 1st, I came to church. When I first heard about tithes, I was skeptical about giving my tithes because the pastor will constantly say things about the tithes. And I wasn't really aware of that I really had to pay my tithes until the pastor showed us in the Bible that we do need to be paying our tithes, 10% of our tithes, of our earnings, or whatever we get in our hands. We need to be giving 10% of that. And until he showed me that, I was skeptical not giving up my tithes. But as soon as I started doing my tithes, anything I earned or got from my check, it went straight. I took that off, the 10% off first, and gave my tithes. Constantly, I started seeing changes. Changes with my housing, changes with keeping money in my pocket. I don't want for nothing. I have no complaints. Now, a friend of mine said God told him to take me back to the car lot and pick out another vehicle. So I decided to go, and I looked at a 300C, but I said I didn't want it. So when I looked to my right and I seen the GMC red, I said, that's the one I'm gonna get. I went into the office and they approved me less than 5 minutes for that GMC. Then they told me that I have to have a certain amount of money to get it. And I told him I didn't have it, and that's not what God said. He just told me to come here, pick out another vehicle. So when I picked out that vehicle, and I told him I'll come back when I get up the money that they was asking for. So I came across a nice lump sum of money, like $5,000, and I took 15 of that 5,000 and took it back up to the car lot. Before I got there, I called him and said, was the truck still there? He said, oh yeah, you need to come up here and get your truck. I said, I'm on my way to come and get my truck. I drove off November 1st off the lot with that GMC. I done had her a while now, but I had no problems with her either. Not one. Because I gotta believe that God gave me that. I don't regret being a faithful tither.
I will prevent pests from devouring your crops. And the vines in your field will not drop their fruit before it is ripe, said the Lord Almighty. Tithe prospers and protects you. There are two ways to return your tithe to the Lord. Give us a call, 1-888-691-2291. A representative is ready to assist you through the secure process of returning your tithe. Write a check or money order and mail it to the Universal Church, 7075 Southwest Freeway, Houston, Texas, 77074. Return your tithe to the Lord today.
A relationship with God means that you have communion with Him. You are not a stranger before the Lord. The Lord is not a stranger to you. You know each other. Even though God knows all about us, you need to know the Lord. When I say know the Lord, to your mind comes, I already go to church, I already know the Bible. If we start talking now, you are going to recite a lot of Bible verses. It doesn't mean you have a relationship with God. You know the Bible, very good. You go to a church, very good. But question, who is God? Who is the Lord? You know the name of your pastor, you know your church, you know all about Abraham, Jacob, Isaac, all about King David, Daniel. You know the Bible from Genesis to Revelation. But who is the Lord? Who is the Lord? I have never met the president of the States. I hear about him. I see him on the TV. I read about him. But I have never met him. It has been your relationship with God. You have heard about Him. You read about Him. But you have not known the Lord. Therefore, this Sunday, you have an opportunity to know the Lord. You have an opportunity to enter into a covenant, a relationship with the Lord. We are going to have the Lord's Supper tomorrow. You are going to eat, you are going to drink from the Lord. Throughout of the day, in our church, you are going to have the opportunity to eat and drink from the Lord. 7 in the morning, also. 10 in the morning, in the afternoon. 3 in the afternoon, and in the evening, 6 p.m. You are going to have an opportunity to participate of the Lord's table. You are going to eat from His body. You are going to drink from Him, His blood, grape juice, and you are going to have a packed communion with the Lord. That's my address, 7075 Southwest Freeway. This church will be open tomorrow. Come as you are. I say to you, come as you are.
He suffered, groaned. No one has ever felt the pain He endured. How could someone so perfect and great be willing to sacrifice for those who are so flawed and unworthy? He carried our sins until death, until the tomb. All so that He could reach out His scarred hands and offer us the cup of salvation that He won for us on Calvary. Whoever rejects this cup rejects His sacrifice. They don't realize the immensity of what it all means. Whoever reaches out their hands to take this cup is placing the Lord Jesus first above all in their lives. The Lord who has saved their lives. This Sunday, we will be together with the Lord's Supper at 10 a.m. in a Universal Church near you.
Jesus, come, we worship you. As we eat this bread, we honor you. And we offer you our lives as you have offered yours for us.
The Lord will do for you. Maybe you think, you say, God has not done anything for me. Tomorrow is a day for you to remember all God has to do in your life. Right now we are going to pray. I have my water. Get yours. Let us pray. Let us talk to God. O Holy Spirit, my Lord and Father, God of the Bible, God that never fails, you are the same yesterday, today, and you shall be forever. My Lord, I pray for this person that is watching me for the first time ever. First time ever. She's watching me this Saturday, and she is grieving. He is alone, lonely in the house, like the gentleman, anonymous, that called us. Jesus, this disperse, the building is so small, but for this person, this house is very big because she is alone, moving from the living room to the bedroom to the kitchen, all alone, not just one day, but she has been lonely for the past 10 years or so. Lord, provide to this person a family, the right person. God Almighty, hear my cry, hear my prayer. Wipe away the tears of this person that lost someone in life, somebody that passed away, somebody that just passed in this family, a family member, and now this person is grieving, is in pain. Oh Lord, you are the comforter. So come, Holy Spirit, to do what words cannot do. My Lord Jesus Christ, I ask you, bless this family, bring them together as one. Bless this inmate, so-called offender. Transform this person right now. Let this person's life shine high and above. Lord Jesus Christ, I bless this cup of water. Let they drink and receive thy power. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Let us drink it together.
This cup, we worship you. As we eat this bread, we honor you. And we offer you our lives as you have offered yours for us.
Nori, our program this Saturday, less talk and more power. The church will be open every single day, as you heard. However, Nori, which are the ways that the viewers can connect with us? because we are with this network, in this channel. But if this person is not watching us on this channel, this TV provider, they can still like watching us online. Tell us about it.
That's correct. There's so many ways that all the viewers can stay connected with us, even if you're not tuned into this channel right now. But when you do scan our QR code, it will direct you to so many links. It will direct you to the links of the website of the church, also our Facebook page, our YouTube page. This is the QR code that you can be able to scan, even share with your friends, with your loved ones as well. When you do scan it, you will receive all the links. We also have the website that you can feel free to visit. We have our Facebook page, our YouTube page. You can also be able to click the links for you to download our apps if you have Android or iOS. We also have Bishop Joshua's blog, our online radio app as well. That way, when you're on the go, you can feel free to stay tuned. And also the locations, our many locations that we do have. So these are all the links that you will see when you do scan this QR code. But we have come to the end of our program. And until one more showdown of faith, God bless all of you.